Well, we're down here and we're in the Kerstetter pits again, which is really great. Got Randy Kerstetter here, Trent's dad. How about predator racing, Randy?
Well, I never thought we'd be racing predators at Penn's Creek, but here we are.
Yeah, I was thinking probably at maybe Rocky Top, but not at Penn's Creek.
Not at Rocky Top and Pinnacle.
I really think, I mean, we have 22 entries right now, and there's a couple guys that have carts out here that didn't sign them up yet. They were looking for drivers. They brought them, and they didn't have drivers for them, so we could end up with maybe 23 or 4 entries.
That's good. That's why we're here. We thought that would bring some competition out to race with, so here we are.
I'll tell you what, I mean, these guys, I mean, they're spending $1,200, $1,400 for these engines, depending on where you go. And, I mean, $100 and slap it on there.
Right, right.
That's got to be a winner right there.
That is a winner.
All right, well, I'll let you get to work here. It's, I mean, 22 carts, it's great to line up with that kind of field.
It is. It's something to race against. It's good to see it.
Yeah. And they're racing for $50.
Oh, yeah, $50, too.
Yeah, that says something about the sport, doesn't it?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
All right.
Round for one class, so hopefully we get to keep it this way, and the people that can afford to do this can come out and do it more often.
Yeah, the idea was to shave about $1,000 off the cost of a motor.
Yeah, that's a hell of an idea. I hope it stays that way. I don't know how we can go back to it, but it sure is a hell of a start, and you guys are doing a good job promoting it, and I hope it catches on.
It's amazing that 22 guys showed up. Some of them are Burris Money Series drivers. It's amazing that they would come out here and run for $50.
Well, it goes back to the competition again, Johnny. It goes all back to the competition for the love of the sport. We was at Seven Stars last night. They had a pretty good count in the Predator Series. So maybe some motor guys are cringing right now. But us guys have got to pay for all this racing or not. So hopefully I'd like to see it catch on.
Well, you mentioned motor guys. And you know Cliff, I know you know him real well, Cliff Loss, JC Specialties. He's one of the biggest motor suppliers in the country, and he's behind this Predator thing 100%.
Well, that's awesome, and I agree with that. He's also a supplier, so there's motor guys out there that's all they do is do motors. So those are the ones I was talking about, not JC Specialties.
I gotcha. Yeah, he's looking to sell tires and go-karts and jackets and helmets and all the other stuff.
Yeah, so hopefully it catches on, man. We're looking for a good race, and it's a great turnout tonight, and appreciate y'all putting the show on, and let's see some good racing.
All right, well, I got kind of a favorite here in this race. I got both barrels loaded. Hopefully we can come up with something.
I hope you do, too. I'm rooting for two of them, but you know who I'm rooting for first.
Yeah, I know. That's right. All right, Bill. Hey, thanks. Good talking to you.
All right, thank you.
You bet. All right, we're right here at what I call the railbird fence. This is where the railbirds hang out. And it looks like we're going to have quite a few of them tonight for that Predator feature.
Yeah, it does. Looks like there's 20-some. 28 or something like that, I think.
I don't know the last time that we've had 20-some go-karts in a class.
It's been a long time.
Been a while. That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to get karting built up here a little bit, maybe make it a little bit more affordable.
Yes, that's what the Predator class is, affordable for people that just want to get into racing.
Yeah, and as long as young as the class is, I don't think it's out of hand yet.
No, I don't think at all. I think we're doing good with it.
Well, do you have someone out there in the Predators?
Yeah, we have Justin Snow out there in the 21R.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Yeah. He's running pretty good.
Yeah, he runs good over at Seven Stars, but tonight's his first night we've been here.
A little different here.
Yes, that's what he said. The track's a little different, so.
We found that a lot of it is gearing. I mean,
yes. 80% of it's gearing. And then getting the cart so it ain't loose or tight. You know, you got to get your car working, yeah.
And every time you turn the steering wheel, it slows it down a little bit.
Absolutely. Yep.
All right. Hey, good luck.
Okay. Yep. Thank you.
Hey, we're rolling around here through the Barnes pits, and I'm looking at Max Mandible here. And Max, you were out on the track for practice in the number 27, and I was watching you out there, and you look good.
Yeah, it felt pretty good. A little bit of stuff to work on yet, but we'll see what we can do.
Well, that's, you know, I've never seen a driver yet come in and say, everything's perfect, don't touch it.
Well, yeah, I think you're right about that, but yeah, second time in a car other than like up at some fun tracks and stuff, so we're going to give it all we got and see.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yep.
Okay, so you're a true rookie then.
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
All right, okay. Well, we dreamed this thing up here over the winter, and we thought we just had to come up with something that was a little more affordable to try and get into.
Yeah, that's for sure. I mean, when you go out to Harbor Freight, you know, and get a $100 motor and put on it and just go have fun, that's what it's all about. That's kind of what I got, why I got into it.
Yeah, that's the deal. And as long as we can hopefully keep the lid on things here, why? And I guess I got a pretty good promise from the cart shops around the area that they're going to try and help, you know, keep the lid on it. So, and the tracks. And if they do that, we'll be good.
Yeah, I mean, hey, like I said, last week was my first week out, and this week's my second week out, and so far I've been having a blast, and it's affordable. It's, I don't know what else you could do to, with only for a couple $100, you know, and have this much fun.
I don't know. Well, there's a couple things I can think of, but it costs a lot more than that.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Yeah. Well, we wish you luck out there, and, I mean, hopefully this will be kind of the kickstart this class. I don't think everybody's going to park these and forget about them after tonight, do you?
No, I don't think so. I think it's just going to grow in the future. I really do. So.
I mean, we have 22 tonight, but I hope next week we have more than three. We've been getting only three here, so hopefully it'll pick up a little.
Yeah, hopefully it does. So.
All right, well, good luck. I know you got some teammates here. I see Tommy's over there, and Billy's running tonight.
Yeah, yep, Billy is. Yeah.
Good to see him back in a cart again. All right, well, I was up there talking to Joe earlier, and he's really happy about it. He thinks that's cool, you know, to have that many.
Yeah, he's ecstatic about it, so.
All right, well, good luck to you.
Hey, thank you.
You bet.
I just got into the throttle too soon, and I got underneath of him, and it just got up wide. And
you didn't hurt the cart any?
Bent the rear axle. That's all it really did, though. I mean, put it out of alignment a little bit, too.
Okay, well, we're glad you weren't hurt.
Yeah, that's the nice thing about these caged carts is that, yeah, I'm pretty big on safety. Like, I have this neck restraint here. Even has restraints to buckle to your helmet so your neck doesn't whip all over the place.
Well, good luck to you tonight. And now that you got all that over with, well, you should have a good night tonight.
Yeah, thank you.
You betcha.
7 of Isaac Schaumer getting hooked up, literally.
Out in front.
All right.
Oh, he's been good. Next to line and a
same step.
Running in the number two spot. This will be to go this time. Running the number 2 spot, the number 15 is Paul Carter. And it appears that tally will finish tonight. Jovi Weller can coast home from there and take the win. Here at Club 375.
Green now. will start at 5th.
17B, next in line. That's Quentin Graham. Like the 40, Tommy Barnes running third on the front straightaway. Followed by his brother, the 19 of Billy Barnes. And we've got a caution. Look at a 17B go. That's Quentin Graham, your new leader. Graham leading down the front stretch. Kirstetter second. Tommy Barnes in the 40. Billy Barnes in the 19. And you. Brent Huffman.
Tammy.
that'll be a half an hour. You know what you do? You put them all where they were the lot before. There she is. You're gonna go, Trent. Get the train before they get scattered.
sister. There's no. Stepsister. Stepbrother. No.
Seven.
them up every Saturday night. I mean, I'm not saying nothing. We got this one tomorrow, and then we got Penn Street here. Then we're done. So we'll see what happens then after that.
Yeah.
someone off the track, they'll lose an entry. They're losing entries anyway because of that.
sportsman right after that. starting coming right here.
Thank you. 25 down, 25 to go.
Well, I got a big gap here, though. Got 20 space. Yeah, he's ahead of us. We are catching slowly.
Maybe that's why it spins out every other lap.
We're flying up behind. I'll never see your face.